Is that okay? Pretty good. Hello, welcome to my channel. I'm Kat. If you are not very interested in Taylor Swift or The Sims, then you might not enjoy this video. But if you are in the percent of people who enjoys one of those things or both of those things, then I think you will enjoy this video. Basically, I was inspired by Little Simsy's video where she did every room of a house was a Taylor Swift album. I thought it would be fun to do a whole house per album, anticipating, and I already have done another one, doing all of the albums as houses, because if you could combine all my interests, it's pretty much this. So that's what this video is. It's going to be a speed build of me building a house inspired by Speak Now, the album. Grab a coffee or a snack and join me as I talk about this house that I built on The Sims. The overall inspiration was kind of like a church and a castle, but I want it to be a house. And it's only one bedroom because Taylor was the only writer on this album, so I thought it'd be fitting that it was just one bedroom. It was inspired partially by the castle that is in the music video at the end of Bejeweled, where they're playing the Long Live instrumental and there's dragons and stuff. Definitely like a nod to Speak Now. I wanted it to be a little bit church looking because the song itself, Speak Now, takes place in a church, and also the song Would've, Could've, Should've, which is about John Mayer, who inspired a few songs on Speak Now. There's a lot of references to like stained glass windows and church and religion, so kind of that was like my inspiration for the architecture. But I will say I quickly learned The Sims has very limited selections for purple walls, like let alone siding itself. I think there was one purple siding, maybe two, and it was a lavender, which I ended up going with, and I did a mix of like brick and stone too. I think my biggest challenge with this was just dealing with the color purple, because there's a million different shades and none of them go together. Like a pinkish purple mauve is not gonna go well with like an indigo. As you know, if you played The Sims, none of the swatches match, so like it was impossible to find two couches that matched, or like two living chairs that matched, or like a like purple dining chairs that went with a table. So yeah, a lot of options were limited, but I kind of just said, you know what, screw it, I'm just gonna have all the purples and make it look okay. It's definitely not like the neatest work, but I saw this as like a creative prompt, and I had a lot of fun with it. I also just don't really like decorating with purple in general. I don't have a lot of purple in my house. I even tried to find a purple mug or a purple shirt for this video, and I don't have it. Like I just don't have anything purple, except ironically my phone case. So I ordered a purple halter top. I also ordered a matching pink one because the Barbie movie's coming out, and I also don't own any pink clothes. I apparently have strayed away from pink and purple clothes for like 5 years. Back to the house. Okay, for the layout of the house, I went in with no plan. I just knew I wanted a turret. Also, yes, I am aware that this shirt is probably far more relevant for like debut or lover. So if you see me wear it again, just keep it to yourself. I also, I added a pond to this house because obviously I felt like there had to be water of some sort, because I remember we were sitting there by the water. I put a lot of lyric references around the house. So if you do download this, obviously I'll show you in this video, but there are some that kind of get skimmed over or that are left for you to find if you end up downloading this house. And also the tree that I put in the backyard, it kind of reminded me of the Mine music video where all the pictures are hanging from the trees. I think my favorite part of the house is probably the back deck. I just really liked how I did the, I don't know what it's called, trellis top, but I liked how it turned out. I liked that the wisteria is on the side. I had the song The Lake stuck in my head the whole time I was decorating that, which is a totally different album. It was fun to revisit this album and listen to it while I was making it, because I don't go back to it a ton. It helped familiarize me again before the new one comes out. I don't know if you'll see in this video, but one of the balconies on the house reminded me a lot of the balcony from the Speak Now tour. I also, okay, so upstairs, there's like a walk-in closet, and I wanted one of the rooms in the house to look haunted because of the song. And so I chose the walk-in closet, and I also really wanted the house to have an organ, because speak now. So I put the organ up there because it just like did not look right in the rest of the house. I also actually really ended up liking the upstairs bedroom. I had a really hard time picking like wallpaper, flooring. The bed took me forever. You won't see in this video, but it took me forever because the purple swatches in The Sims just suck. Like, they're horrible. Or the vibe was wrong. Like, it was too like boho or too childish or something. So I found one and I ended up just going crazy and doing like, you know, posts and like curtains and getting more creative than I usually do. Feels like a princess bedroom. And I also tried to keep it like kind of young because she was still really young when she wrote this album. I'm working on the house for Red next, actually, because it's my favorite album. This is so random and kind of lame, but I made it like a numeric or like quantitative analysis of like what is actually my ranking of Taylor's albums, and I made this before Midnights came out, and I still don't know where it ranks. If you're curious, in order from my most liked to least liked, here's my ranking. So number one is Red, 2 is Reputation, 3 is Folklore, 4 is Speak Now, 5 is Fearless, 6 is Lover, 7 is Evermore, 8 is 1989, and 9 is Taylor Swift. Now, if I had to add Midnights in there, I would guess that it's probably bumped to number 4 under Folklore and before Speak Now. How I ranked these was actually like my brother's idea. It was like, out of all the songs, how many do I enjoy? Like, how many do I genuinely like? And how many do I go back to and actually listen to a lot? And then I like averaged the two percentages of those. Also, caveat, I did not include the deluxe versions when I did this. And now my curiosity is piqued and I'm gonna go do Midnights. Okay, I like about 17 out of 20. And then I go back and listen to 11. Very interesting. Wow, the math. I was exactly right. It actually is number 4 after Folklore and above Speak Now. That's crazy. It's raining. I'm trying to think of some Easter eggs I put in this. You'll see at the end, I'll do a walkthrough. And either during the walkthrough or during the slide of pictures, I put the lyric references that I captured. I'm gonna cut off this video now. My main motivation to do that is because I'm running out of card space and I don't feel like digging for another one. So enjoy the rest of the speed build and I will see you in the next video. I hope you enjoyed. And if you are interested in seeing more of this type of video, please let me know by giving me a thumbs up on this video. Also, if you are a fan of Taylor Swift, tell me what your favorite album is and also what your favorite song is, if they're different. For me, my favorite album is Red, and my favorite song is the acoustic version of State of Grace. I have to like decide that that's my favorite still because there's so many that I could pick from. I also really love Endgame, Getaway Car, 7, All Too Well, obviously, The Great War. All right, I think that's all I have for you. Thank you for enduring, and if you share these interests, I hope you enjoy. And I hope that this video brought some joy to your day.
I'll see you in the next one. Thank you. lunchbox days. Chalkboard. You gave me roses and I left them there to die. In the room for an empty seat. Your string of lights is still bright to me. At my door, you paint me a blue sky. Lead me up the staircase. Turn my nightlight on. Swords and weapons, and they point to the picture. Dragons! And the organ starts to play. Now I'm haunted. On the mattress, back to December. Sitting there by the water. Firefly catching days. I'm haunted. Chess game, sparks, love, fireworks.
If you happen to be someone who's aware of my Sims channel, I'm now posting everything here. I probably should just post an update on my Sims channel, but it's just easier for me mentally, like with the limited time I have to make videos, it just makes sense for me to have it all in one place. So that's what's happening now. Bye!